Hello friends, welcome to my channel Myself Parag Jambulkar. In this video we will see different parallel algorithm models. So there are several parallel algorithm models. For example, data parallel model, the task graph model, the workflow model, the master slave model, the pipeline are producer consumer model, and last is hybrid models. So we'll see this model one by one. The first one is data parallel model. So in this case, data is divided or allocated to different tasks or different processes to work out. For example, look at the matrix multiplication. Here there are two matrices. This is the first matrix, this is another matrix, and we got resultant matrix. So here these are the four values of the resultant matrix: C1, C2, C3 and C4. C1 is calculated like this, that is A1 into B1 plus A2 into B3. In the same way, C2 is calculated, C3 is calculated, C4 is calculated. If we observe, for calculating this C1, C2, C3, C4, each value requires two multiplications and one addition. Same way, same thing for calculating C2, same thing for calculating C3 and C4. Here, operations are same, but data is getting changed. So that's why it is called a data parallel model. So what we are doing, here we are given C1 to different process to calculate, C2 we are allocated to different processes for calculation, C3 we have allocated different process for calculation, and C4 to other process. And all the processes, they are doing same operation, but only they are using different data. And this is called as data parallel model, where we are dividing our result based on the data, or we are dividing computation based on the data. This is called as data parallel model. Next is task graph model. Here, when there is a big process, we are dividing into the small process or sub processes. That sub process, we are calling it as a task. For example, we have to find out minimum number from the given array. So here we have divided that problem into the small tasks. For example, here this is a one task, another task, third task, fourth task. So this task will find out minimum from these two number. Another task will find out a minimum from these two number. Third task will find out minimum from these two number, and fourth task will find out minimum from these two number. Afterwards, whatever the minimum we get, so this task, now there are two tasks running parallelly. So this task will find out minimum from these two. This task will find out minimum from these two, and whatever the result we get, that last task will find out minimum from this, and we shall, at the end we get the minimum number. So here we have a big problem, we are divided into the small tasks, and this is called as task graph model. There we are divided a big problem into the small tasks, and this is a task dependency graph we got. Next is work pool model. From name we'll come to know, it is a pool. Pool means what? Pool is a collection of something. Okay, so a collection of what? Collection of work, or you can say a collection of tasks. That's why it is called as a work pool model. So basically it used for load balancing. Now what happened? Some processes are very big, some processes are small. So processes which are small get finished earlier, and those are idle, while processes those are long or have more work, they execute for longer time. So to avoid that, we have to balance the load. So for that purpose, what we are doing, we are creating a pool of tasks, we are creating a pool of work. So we are not allocating this work to any processes before, we are keeping a set of work, a set of tasks, and at runtime we are allocating tasks to different processes. So whatever the process is idle, we'll allocate tasks to that process, and in this way we are balancing the load. So again, process in the sense, whatever the computation that is going on the processor core, that we are calling processes. So process is running on the processor core, and whatever the task or whatever the work are there, so we are making a bunch of that, we are making a group of that, we are making a collection of this work, and at runtime, whatever the process which has finished first or whatever the process is idle, so we'll allocate that task to that particular process so that no process will be idle and it will increase the performance. And such kind of model is called as work pool model. Next is master slave model. Here from name we'll come to know, one process is a master and another processes are slave. In the sense, here work is distributed among the different processes. So one process is called as a master process, while other processes are called as slave process. So whichever the master process, it is allocating work to different processes. That is called as a master process. Master process is allocating tasks to other slave processes. And this model is called as a master-slave model. Next is pipeline or producer-consumer model. So pipeline architecture we already know. What about pipeline architecture? There are different stages. For example, phase, decode, execute, write back. In the same way, what we are doing, one task is going through the many processes. So one task will come, one process will work on it, then second process will work on it, then third process will work on it, then next process will work on it. As first process has done its work, next it will take another task. So here in pipeline model, one task, okay, one problem is going through many processes. Many processes are there, those are working on the given task. And how the processes are working? First process will work, then second process will work, then third process will work, then next process will work. By the time first process has completed its work, so that task will given to the next process, and in that time first process will get another task. Just like pipeline model we have already seen, in the same way we are giving tasks and task is going through many processes. Many processes are working on that task but in a sequential manner, and this is called as pipeline or producer consumer model. Then combinations of above models is called as a hybrid model. When we are using multiple models together, then such kind of models are called as hybrid model. So these are the different parallel algorithm models. The first is data parallel model, where we are dividing computation based on the data. Then we have task graph model. Here we are dividing big problem into the small problem, that is called as a task graph model. Then we have work pool model. So we have bunch or group of work or task, and at runtime we are allocating that task to particular process which is idle. Then we have master slave model, where master process is allocating work to different processes for the load balancing. That is called as a master slave model. Then pipeline model or producer consumer model, where single task is going through many processes. So one process will work, then second process will work, then third process will work, then next process will work. So whatever the process has done completed work on that particular task, so that process will work on another task. That is called like the pipeline or producer consumer model. And combination of above models is called as the hybrid models. So these are the examples of parallel algorithm models. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.